Good morning, this is Kasturi Day. Today I am going to discuss and continue the chapter circulation, circulatory system in humans. Okay, so in my last two videos I discussed about the introduction and about the heart's internal structure, okay, and the position of the heart. Now I'm starting with the heart's natural pacemaker. Okay, what is the heart's natural pacemaker? The heart's natural pacemaker is the SA node. And what is that? It is a sinoatrial node, which is present as a cluster of cells in the upper part of the right auricle. From the picture you can see the right auricle. You can see the right auricle, dark brown color, and the green color pointing, one is at the above, okay, near the superior vena cava, and another is towards the in the down position, in the right auricle only. Another is in the down position and lower position, near the right ventricle. Okay, so first one, that is towards the superior vena cava, towards the entry of the superior vena cava, there is one green cluster of cells that is known as the SA node, sinoatrial node. Okay, and the lower one is the atrioventricular node, which is continuing as Purkinje fibers inside the ventricular septum. Okay, interventricular septum. It is continuing in the interventricular septum, and also in the it is spreading towards the both the sides of the ventricles. Okay, now this, the initiation of the heart rhythm, okay, it starts as electric impulse. It's just electric shock. It starts from this SA node. Okay, initiation of the rhythmic movement of the heart, that is starting from this SA node initiation. Okay, the SA node is the initiation of this rhythm, heartbeat rhythm, okay, as an electrical impulse. Okay, now the walls of the heart are formed of the cardiac muscles. Okay, now these muscles, we know that it is made up of cardiac muscles, and these muscles rhythmically, continuously, contracting and relaxing to pump blood throughout the body, and this contraction is initiated by the SA node. The first initiation is done by the SA node, and if the SA node is defective, there is the heart rhythms also become defective. It becomes abnormal, like it either beats too fast or it beats too slow or a combination of the two. Okay, if it beats too fast, then it is tachycardia, and if it beats too slow, then it is bradycardia. Okay, the two conditions happening, and when it is a combination of the two, that is tachybradycardia syndrome, it's happening. Next, we are coming to the circulation of the blood. Okay, so the blood, I told you, when it enters the right auricle, the deoxygenated blood enters from the whole body via the vena cava to the right auricle. Okay, vena cava, from the superior vena cava and inferior vena cava, they bring the blood from the whole parts of the body to the right auricle. It enters the right auricle, then it passes to the right ventricle, then to the pulmonary artery, and it moves to lungs for purification. There the purified oxygenated blood now comes to the left auricle. Okay, now left auricle pumps blood to the left ventricle, and from the left ventricle it moves to the aorta, from the aorta to the different arteries, and it moves to the whole body, this oxygenated blood. Okay, this is the circulation which takes place inside our body. Now There are valves, I told you. One is between the tricuspid valve, which is between the right and the left ventricle, and the left, I mean right and the right ventricle, right or atrium and the right ventricle, and then left atrium and left ventricle, there is bicuspid valve. And the semilunar valves, are one is pulmonary semilunar valves between the ventricle, right ventricle and pulmonary artery. And this is aortic semilunar valve is between left ventricle and the aorta. Now this moves on like this, lungs, when the pulmonary vein arteries go to the lungs, there the exchange of gases takes place, that is carbon dioxide is given out from the deoxygenated blood and oxygen is taken in to form the oxygenation of the blood. So this is carried out in this this circulation carries on inside our heart, inside the whole body of our of the human beings in this way. Now see, in this circulation there are two circulation taking place, one is pulmonary circulation, another is systemic circulation. Okay, so double circulation is there. Okay, so pulmonary circulation, where the blood is moving from the left right ventricle through the pulmonary artery moving to the lungs, that is deoxygenated blood is moving to the lungs, it gets purified and become oxygenated and comes back to the right auricle. So this is a complete, I mean it will move, it coming out to the left auricle, sorry, to it is coming to the from the lungs via the pulmonary veins, it is coming to the left auricle. So this is a complete pulmonary circulation. Now the blood, from when it moves from the left auricle to left ventricle, and from left ventricle when it is moving to the aorta and moving through whole body, it is then becoming deoxygenated, and via the superior and inferior vena cava it is entering into the what is called the right auricle. So this is the systemic circulation. Okay, now both these circulations takes place in the rhythmic way, okay, and together constituting the cardiac cycle. And now this double circulation, that double circulation is proposed by English medical doctor who was known as William Harvey. Okay, then for one complete circulation, one round of circulation, the heart, I told you there's a double circulation, so the body passes, the blood passes through the heart by two ways, I mean the blood passes twice in the heart, through the heart. Okay, it's not body, the blood passing through the heart is twice. Okay, now the heart and the cardiac cycle, what is cardiac cycle and the what is heartbeat. Okay, so the auricles, I told you, the auricles first it contracts. Now the blood is forced into the ventricles. After a fraction of a second, the ventricles contract, pushing the blood into the pulmonary arteries and aorta. Now the auricles then relax. Okay, then the blood flows into the aortic auricles from pulmonary veins and vena cava. Within this time, the ventricles also have emptied the blood and the ventricles now relax. Okay, then the whole heart relaxes. This total process, that is from auricle contracting till the whole heart relaxing, this is known as the heartbeat, total process. Therefore, the heartbeat is one complete pulsation. What is pulsation? It is beating or throbbing of the heart, including one complete systole and diastole. I'll discuss with what is systole and diastole. In my next slide, I'll discuss it, okay? So, this sequence of events that taking place during one complete heartbeat, that is known as the cardiac cycle, okay? From the picture, you can see, they see that there is a arterial systole, then is an then ventricular systole, then the diastole. Okay, see, now what we come to the systole and diastole condition. What is that? It involves a repeated contraction. Systole is repeated contraction, that is one we are seeing that artery is contracting pushing the blood into the ventricles. Then ventricles contracting, pushing the blood into the arteries, that is pulmonary artery and aorta. So this is systole condition, and relaxation is the diastole condition. When the arteries are relaxing, auricles are relaxing, then the ventricles are relaxing, the heart is relaxing, that is the diastole condition. So one cardiac cycle is equal to one systole plus one diastole. That lasts for about 0.8 seconds. Okay, and during this cardiac cycle, this is the heartbeat, you can say, and in this there is two sounds heard. Okay, one is lub, one is dub. Okay, so first the contraction of the auricles, that is the weak sound, and then the contraction of the ventricles, that is a strong sound. Okay, now the doctor uses stethoscope to hear this sound. Okay, this heartbeat. A normal heart on an average beats 72 times per minute. Okay, now we come to the pulse. See, the heartbeat, we can feel it just below the thumb, base of the thumb on the wrist, or at the neck we can feel it. Okay, now the left ventricles contract, moves the blood moves into the arteries under high pressure. Okay, and it creates a pressure on the arterial walls to get stretched. Then ventricles relax, then pressure comes down. So pulse is the stretching and relaxing of the arteries with each heartbeat, that is felt as throbbing. Okay, that is the pulse. Okay, so the arteries stretch and then relax. This is felt as heartbeat. In the as a throbbing, you can feel that is the pulse and that is the rate of the heartbeat. Okay, now I told you it is felt at the side of the neck or at the wrist near the base of the thumb. Healthy adult has 70 to 75 times per minute. This is the pulse rate. Okay, so I'm stopping here. I'll continue with the rest of the chapter in my next video. So please go through this. If you have any doubt, please let me know. If you can write in the comment box, and if you like the video, don't forget to press the like button so that I can produce some more enthusiastic videos for you. And you can also give suggestions to improve my videos so that it can help you a lot in your studies, more in your studies. And if you are a new viewer to my channel or not subscribed yet, please do subscribe to get the notification of my next video. Thank you.